right students. Next question, fourth problem. It is also very very important. Show that the modulus function f is mapping from R to R given by f of x is equal to mod x is neither 1 1 nor onto. So modulus function we have to check. Previously we checked the greatest integer function. Now we will see the modulus function. You learnt first PU this graph also, and also you know the definition. F is mapping from R to R defined by f of x is equal to mod x. What is the definition of modulus function? I will redefine this is f of x is equal to mod x is defined by plus x when x is greater than 0, 0 when x is equal to 0, minus x when x less than 0. I think you understood in the first PU. So x values if you substitute in more than 0, f of x is getting plus x. If you substituting x value is less than 0, f of x is minus x. You just recall the graph. What is graph of modulus function? V shape, you know very well, correct students? So this is the graph of modulus function. So f of x is equal to mod x. Here observe the students, if you substitute, this is an origin, this is positive x, this is negative x, positive y, negative y. If you substitute these values means right side of origin. Right side of origin means x is more than 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, or 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, like these are all more than 0. If you take more than 0, you are getting this branch. This branch is f of x is equal to plus x branch. If you take the negative values, that means left side of origin, negative values. Negative values means smaller than 0. Minus 0.1, minus 0.2, minus 0.3, and so on, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, it goes on. For those values, you are getting this branch. This is f of x is equal to minus x branch. So the minus x branch, plus x branch, both are possible. So if it is exactly 0, if you take, so your answer is 0. X 0, y also 0. If x is, if x is more than 0, you will get this branch. Less than 0, this branch. Now you can observe it here. Now I am taking x, f of x is equal to mod x students. I am taking x1 is equal to plus 1. So f of x is equal to mod x, which is equal to mod of 1 plus 1. At the same time, I am taking minus 1. F of x is equal to mod of minus 1. That is equal to mod of plus 1. Because modulus of a number never negative. So you are giving different inputs, same output. Not only 1 minus 1, you can take 2 minus 2. Giving 2 minus 2, output is 2. Not only minus 1 minus 2, you take minus root 2 plus root 2. Plus only. So if you give different inputs here, you are getting the same output. That's why it is not 1 1 function clearly. Correct students? So you are giving different inputs, getting same output. I told with an example. So I'm taking here. Let x1 is equal to 1, x2 is equal to minus 1. So f of x1 is equal to mod of x1, so mod of plus 1 is equal to 1. Next, f of x2, which is equal to mod of x2, which is equal to mod of minus 1 plus 1. So not only plus 1 minus 1, you can take plus 2 minus 2, plus 3 minus 3, plus 4 minus 4, not only that numbers, minus 0.1 plus 0.1, minus root 3 plus root 3, plus 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2, whatever the inputs if you give, output will be the, whatever the inputs, same input will be numerically same, but magnitude is opposite. Magnitude means sign difference. Plus 1, minus 1, plus 2, minus 2, plus root 3, minus root 3, plus 10, minus 10, plus 100, minus 100. You are getting same output. So according to 1 1 function, different inputs, different outputs, but you are giving different inputs.
x1 is not equal to x2, but whereas f of x1 and f of x2 are equal to the same value,
hence you are giving different inputs but getting same output, it is not 1 1,
therefore f is not a 1 1 function. Understood, students?
Right, I am checking the this is 1 1 function. Next, we want to check the onto function. Onto function or surjunction. One other name, students, injunction. So surjunction onto definition, range is equal to codomain. Here see that it is not 1 1, obviously it is many one. Why? Because two or more elements of first set is having same image. So plus 1 minus 1 is having same image, plus 1, plus 2 minus 2 is having same image, plus 2, plus root 2 minus root 2 is having same image, root 2, like the different inputs same output, that's why it is not 1 1. If a function is not 1 1, it is many 1. So remember it, students. Now on to function or surjunction. So f is mapping from R to R, defined by f of x is equal to mod x. Be careful, students, here. So what is codomain here? Codomain is equal to, this is codomain always, R means real numbers. So real numbers we will denote it as minus infinity to plus infinity. Now what is range? Range means whatever the values, if you substitute here, you won't get the negative values. You can see diagram. Y-axis is totally codomain, but your graph is lies in between 0 to infinity. So you don't have the negative values. Illi graph e illa. So you should get from 0 to, this is positive infinity, 0 to minus infinity. So codomain is codomain R means minus infinity to plus infinity. Where the graph is lies, that is range always. Graph is lies only in this part, correct or not? So where it lies? Above x-axis. Above x-axis, it is from origin 0 to infinite. I'm giving arrow mark means it, if you take different values, it moving infinite distance. Correct or not, students? Now range f of x is equal to, range f of x is equal to, you will get 0 to infinite values only. How would we know? Simple. This is input, real numbers. If you substitute all real numbers, so I will check it with the number line, check it here. So this is 0, students. This is plus infinity. This is minus infinity. If you substitute these values in modulus, you will get the same. If you substitute these values, you will get again positive values. That means this part will cut and overlap here only again. That's why your graph will be here. So positive values, generally you know very well f of x is equal to x identity function. You remember? F of x is equal to x identity function, I told. F is mapping from R to R. Positive values, if you give input, positive output. Negative, negative output. But in this function, if you give positive values, this branch, if you give negative values also, this branch will be turn here. Clear, students? Actually, if it is positive, this branch will come. If it is negative, they must come in identity function like this. But in modulus function is there. In modulus function, y value is never negative. Y value means f of x is equal to mod x. Mod x means modulus of a number is never negative, always positive. That's why this branch will be turn and form like this. This is turning and form like this. So that's why it is a V-shaped. So when it turn, you don't have the negative values in y. Y negative values is not there in this. This is y. Number line is y. So these values are disappear and coincide here only. That's why range f of x is 0 to infinity. So is it same, this value and this value? Not same. Why? Because real number r is equal to combination of minus infinity to 0, union 0, union plus 0 to infinity. All sere real numbers up to this. ఈ పాయింట్ బిట్టి ఇదొస్తు ఇదొస్తు ఈ పాయింట్ త్రీ మిక్స్ ఆగిద్ర రియల్ నంబర్స్. ఇక ఈ వాల్యూస్ ఇల్ల బరే జీరో ఇదే, జీరో టు ఇన్ఫినిటీ ఇదే. దట్స్ వై జీరో ఈజ్ క్లోజ్డ్ బ్రాకెట్. నౌ రేంజ్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు కోడొమైన్. రేంజ్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఈక్వల్ టు కోడొమైన్. హెన్స్ ఎఫ్ ఈజ్ నాట్ onto function. Understood students? Not onto function. Hence f is neither 1 nor onto. So these two are very very important problems, student. Students, next problem, fifth problem in exercise 1.2. It is see that, show that signum function f is mapping from R to R defined by f of x is equal to plus 1 if x greater than 0, 0 when x greater than 0, minus 1 when x less than 0. Show that it is neither 1 nor onto. So this is also graph you are familiar in the first PU, correct or not? So you are familiar with modulus function, greatest integer function, signum function, cubic function, quadratic function, reciprocal function, identity function, constant function. All these graphs you learnt in the first PU, and you know the what is its domain and what is its range. So you have to command and domain and range, domain and range, then only you can do problems are very easy. See, what is signum function you learnt in the first PU? F of x is equal to mod x upon x or x upon mod x. Both are signum functions only. This is representation of signum function. Sir, f of x is equal to mod x upon x. You know very well, mod x is a modulus function. Modulus function again redefined by plus x, 0, and x, plus x, minus x. Plus x is x greater than 0, correct students? X is equal to 0, x less than 0. So this is numerator value we defined. Denominator, you can write as it is x, no problem in this. Correct students? Once again, listen careful. So mod x is defined, plus x, numerator only, I am defining only numerator. Plus x, when x greater than 0, mod x is 0 when x is 0, mod x is minus x when x less than 0. So denominator x I substituted like this. Now plus x by x you can cancel, you will get plus 1. 0 by anything is 0. So minus x by plus x is minus 1, correct or not? So like you are getting 1, 0, minus 1. How you are getting these values means, if you define like this, you will get these values. This is the signum function. In signum function, you learnt in the first PU graph. Do you familiar that graph? Is very very important, these graphs are. So if you take, this is x positive, x negative, this is y positive and y negative, this is an origin. If x values are this side, that means x is greater than 0. Greater than 0 means 0 is not included, students. So that case, what is your answer? X is greater than 0, your answer becomes 1. That's why I am taking here one point is 1. But here you have to make as whole. This is very very important. That means if x is 0, it is not 1. That's why we are making a whole here. Except this point, all values
0.01, 0.02, 0.31, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6, 1, all x greater than 0. X greater than 0 means we have 0 to infinite values.
0 include agilla nodri. Adikana 0 include agilana, so that place you should not touch the line.
E line y-axis ni touch agabaradu. Yakante x lo 0 include agilla. That is very very important. That time f of x is equal to 1. So if you take x place 0 to infinity.
0 to infinity means s to values edavo, infinite values edavo. Infinite input ki output 1. Only one value. So you are giving different inputs, output is only one. Like if suppose x is less than 0 also 0 not included.
In that case, x is less than 0, f of x value is minus 1. So it is minus 1, your line will not touch the y-axis. That's why I am putting as whole. So x less than 0, this is answer. X greater than 0, this is answer. If x is equal to 0, this is answer.
Now, what is your range? Range means graph.
L is the graph, minus 1 atra. Plus 1, 0. So range is equal to, you written in the first PU, 0 plus or minus 1. This is range.
But in this graph, what is codomain? Real numbers. But range codomain equal illaga. So it is not onto function. Now how to check 1-1 function? You are giving different input. Different input means 0 admela infinite varaku. You are substituting 0 to infinite. Except 0. 0 after to infinite. All values output plus 1. Here you are giving 0 minus 0 before. That means you can take minus infinity to 0. All input. These are all x values. This is belongs to f, x. So my f of x is minus 1 answer. But these are belongs to x values. What is f of x value? Plus 1. So infinite inputs ki output on the ide.
Different inputs ki different outputs banda 1-1 function.
Different inputs ki same output. Different inputs ki same output. So it is not 1-1. Clear students? Let I will discuss here. See.
Solution. 1-1 function. Or injunction. So f is mapping from R to R defined by f of x is equal to minus 1 plus 1 when x greater than 0, 0, x is equal to 0, minus 1, x less than 0. These are the defined values.
See that x greater than 0 means, see first case.
If x greater than 0, that implies x is belongs to 0 to infinite. Correct or not?
More than 0. 0 include agilla. 0 bit all values right side.
Idashtu all values. For these all values, f of x is given 1.
We have infinite inputs. Output is same.
Similarly, if x is less than 0, that implies x is belongs to minus infinity to 0.
All 0 below values, that means my negative values are all.
F of x is equal to minus 1.
Clear students? That's why you are giving different inputs but getting same output. You write here, as x1 is not equal to x2, but f of x1 is equal to f of x2, hence f is not 1-1 function. 1-1 function or injunction. Clear students? Right. Now we are going to check onto function.
R surjunction. R surjunction.
See, what is meant by onto function and surjunction? I told range is equal to codomain. Correct or not? Simple definition.
So, F is mapping from R to R, redefined by F of x is equal to 1 when x greater than 0, 0 when x is equal to 0, minus 1 when x less than 0.
What is codomain in this problem?
Codomain is equal to, this is the value. So, R means all real numbers. Real numbers are usually denoted with the interval brackets minus infinity to plus infinity. Now, what is range here? Range means where the graph is lies. Here, minus 1 is one graph, plus 1 is one line at 0. So, range is equal to, we have 0 plus or minus 1.
Only three values are here. Here we have infinite values. So, range and codomain, is it equal?
No. So, codomain is not equal to range. Hence, F is not onto function. So finally you can write F is neither 1-1 nor onto function. Clear students?
Right. So the next law, sixth one. Students, next sixth problem. Set A is given set of 1, 2, 3. Set B is given set of 4, 5, 6, 7. And the function F is mapping from A to B. How they are mapping? 1, 4 ordered pair, 1, 4 ordered pair, 2, 5 ordered pair, 3, 6. B a function from A to B. Show that F is 1, 1 function. So, they told it is a function. We have to prove that it is a 1, 1 function. What is meant by 1, 1 function? Different inputs, different outputs. Correct or not? Now, I will explain with a diagram. So, this is set A and this is set B. Set A is given 1, 2, 3 elements. Set B is given 4, 5, 6, 7. A function is mapping from, F is mapping from A to B. How they mapped here given the conditions? 1 is associated with 4, 2 is associated with 5, 3 is associated with 6. By this, F is equal to set of ordered pair 1 comma 4, ordered pair 2 comma 5, ordered pair 3 comma 6. I told a function is said to be, a relation is said to be a function, no two ordered pairs of F have the same first coordinate. So, this is a function. Why? Because you can check any two ordered pairs. They don't have the same first coordinate. First coordinate is different. Here it is different, here it is different. Now, here you can see that different inputs, output is different. So, F of 1, 4, F of 2, 5, F of 3, 6. So, we are giving different inputs, getting different outputs. Hence, it is a 1, 1 function. You can write it here as x1 is not equal to x2. That implies F of x1 is not equal to F of x2. So, different inputs for getting different outputs. Hence, F is a 1, 1 function. Students, is it onto function? No. Why? Because onto function means I told for every element of set B, there exists at least one pre-image in A. There is an element 7 in set B without pre-image. That's why it is not onto. It is a 1-1 because different inputs, different outputs. It is not onto function. and to function another definition, what is that? Range is equal to codomain. What is range? Which elements of B is associated with A? 4, 5, 6 is associated with A. So 4, 5, 6 is range. Codomain means 4, 5, 6, 7. These two are not equal. Correct or not? There is a shortage of 6. Correct or not? That's why range is not equal to codomain. Or for every element in the set B, at least exist at least one pre-image in set A. But 7 is an element without pre-image. That's why it is not a onto function. This is just one function. Clear, students? Right.